jest podobno mega zrobiona mapka z Valheima. Start to finish, building a full adventure map in Valheim. 18 minut budowania mapki w Valheimie. Jestem mega ciekaw, jak to wygląda. Wydaje mi się, że Asmongold kiedyś to oglądał. I więc pewnie zrobili mu widzowie research, że to nie jest byle co. Zobaczmy, jak to się prezentuje. To na pewno to.
For the last year, I've dreamt of building the ultimate Valheim world. A world that has enough things in it to feel like an open world RPG game. So eventually, there's going to be an entire town right here at Worldspawn. Okay, so this is off the edge of the world. This is where I want to eventually have, well, everything.
5 miast, 37 lokacji, areny z bossami.
Now from the beginning, I knew that a world like this would be borderline impossible to complete alone. So I looked into my long list of associates that could actually help me with this, and yeah. All jokes aside, I had a friend who goes by Dakar, who just so happens to be a bit of a legend among Valheim builders.
O kurna, on to w Valheimie zbudował?
At the end of the video, I'll talk about how you can play the...
Czekaj. Valheim... Jak to? Dakar? Drakar? Nie, to jest ship. Czekajcie, bo jestem ciekaw, czy on ma kanał swój. I czy ktoś go docenia w ogóle. Thakhar. 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 Valheim Mechanicus. No niektóre tak, ale niektóre totalnie zero. RPG Inside Valheim from Idea to Reality. O, to też trzeba będzie kiedyś obejrzeć. Ale tak różnie. Jezus, ile go to pracy kosztowało. Podupcone.
At the end of the video, I'll talk about how you can play this world yourself, modded, unmodded, and in a couple of different ways. But let's get into the story of how we built this and why we waited so long to get started. On November 5th at 11:23 a.m., I got a message asking me if I wanted to be a builder on a Valheim RPG experience, built for a large 1 million follower streamer. Fast forward to the next day, and I was on a phone call with one of the top mod developers involved in the project. On this call, I found out that there was an entire team of modders already working to make a full-on RPG experience with unique loot, 12 different unique player classes, and even quests that could be received from NPCs and then completed, all coming together in one ultimate mod pack. If you've played Valheim at all, you know that this
Nie,
is very impressive. Now pause. Remember what I said earlier about how we've been planning this? I've dreamt already off and on for over a year. Well, at this point, now that I know this thing is for real, I think you know my answer.
Yes.
By the way, the mysterious streamer I mentioned, I found out that this is Gathalion, a variety gaming streamer that does in fact have 1 million followers, but more importantly, that also has a whole community of people playing Valheim and talking every day on his Discord server. So as for the reason why we waited until now, well, it was a lot of work, so we needed some extra motivation, and this situation was perfect. Dakar and I finally getting to build what we wanted, and for a guy that would make sure that the most people possible got to enjoy it. So after a year of planning, it was finally time to start building. Well, no, actually, it started off with more planning, for 2 weeks to be exact. Had to decide how the world...
Nie patrzyłem w sumie, Silon, na maila. Nie patrzyłem. Czy zagrasz z w Koda nie zagram Rosemary z tobą w Koda. Jakby ktoś inny zapytał, to bym zagrał, ale z tobą nie. Mechanics would work. It went kind of like this. First, we found out that they wanted more hardcore travel, which meant only 5 portals would be allowed in 5 main towns. Then we heard how important the 12 player classes in the Legends mod would be, so we decided to theme 12 more areas to those classes. Then finally, there was a decision made on amped up raid-like boss fights that take entire raiding parties to beat, so boss arenas would also have to be built. And then of course, this is an open world, so we needed to have a bunch of locations in between everything. So yeah, that's 37 builds in total, all connected by roads and bridges. This is definitely when the uneasiness of how much work it was really set in. But not even nervous butterflies could hide the fact that it was now 2 weeks since I received that first message. All I wanted to do was start some real planning.
This is where I want to eventually have...
And now finally, it was time to place down the first blueprint. Co oni budowali jakieś pojedyncze rzeczy i później je łączyli? The next task was to go through and break apart these builds, creating an almost ominous build graveyard with endless nothingness except broken down builds as far as the eye could see. But as more builds were taken apart, new useful areas were created. We suddenly had bridges, lamp posts, pagodas, entrances, and all sorts of things that could be quickly grabbed or modified or used for inspiration. And finally, a few days after placing down all of the blueprints, I could actually start building. I started by taking my Viking outpost build and breaking it apart. I loved the theme of this build, and I knew I could play off of that to create a themed village. I took the build and chopped off the front, cleaned it up, and created a medium-sized version. And then I made the smallest version, which got some new features on the side. Then I moved on to the Viking Tavern build. Here, I had a bit more trouble separating the complex shapes that made up the build. After a while, I was successful, and once again, I created 3 versions, large, medium, and small. I did the same thing with an old starter house. Then I modified an old portal building. Then some builds that had been used in the background of a video. Oof. Kurczę, ładne te budynki, ale no jednak widać uproszczenie w tych kształtach. Może nie w kształtach, ale w tych teksturach. Może to trochę przeszkadzać. I teraz sobie tak myślę, że w tym Enshrouded faktycznie ładniejsze i bardziej pełne detali budynki można robić, nie? Up until this point, I guess the highlight of the story has been finally getting to work out on the edge of the world with builds, and while that was a great milestone after waiting a year to get to this point, it was actually nothing compared to what started. Myślę, że mało kto rozmarzy. To jakby ludzie w to grają, ale ci, co grali na mobilnych telefonach, a wśród takich pecetowych raczej mało kto w to gra, no to nie jest gra na standardy pecetowe, po prostu. Najlepsze jest to, nie wiem, znowu widzowie jacyś mówili, że dlaczego nazywam tą grę mobilną, jak tutaj jest tyle mechanik, tyle ciekawych rzeczy. No i teraz by pasowało, wiecie, znaleźć te komentarze i napisać im, jak się teraz bawią. Jak tam hype, jak tam nowy, wiecie, MMRPG na lata, nie? Ale komu się chce? I received that first message. Oh. On the 25th of November, I started working on the 5 main towns. Finally. Which actually cover all of the biomes in the game. I'll be working on the Meadows, the Plains, and the Black Forest Mountain Town. Dakar will be working on the Swamp, and the 5th is a bit of a surprise, but obviously it's the Mistlands. Now my 3 towns are laid out with some similarities that, in my opinion, make a town feel real. The first similarity would be placing each town's largest build on the highest ground. The second similarity would be choosing a themed set of buildings for each town. So, remember those buildings that I made different versions of?
For the meadows, I chose the Viking Tavern. I placed the largest of the three variations at the top of the artificially added high ground, and I even did it across the river from the boss stones so that I could add a fancy bridge, which is the same thing I did with the medium-sized build, except down a little lower. Then I placed the smaller size build right next to the stones.
Urocze to. Ładne, nie? Budujesz, kurczę, no budujesz swoimi budowlami, tworzysz taki klimacik fajny i później chodzisz sobie między tym, zajebiste. Cześć nomad, witam, witam.
That was previously used in the background of a video. Once again, I used the largest at the top of the hill, and then I placed the other two sizes scattered along the ridge, with also some smaller houses too. For the Black Forest Mountain Town, I brought in the Viking Tavern build, and I placed the largest version at the top, and then the two smaller down lower with more extra houses. The next similarity in each town was something to tie it into the biome or the setting that it was in. I started with the Meadows again, which is the only town built next to the Boss Stones. So I brought in my modified portal building and placed it around the boss stones for a secure place to put boss stones.
Ale szczęście, że miał gotowe już template'y przygotowane, bo to by była masakra.
So of course I went and got Yaglith's fingers from the boss altar, making it seem like the town was almost being held up by Yaglith himself. And I even added a fancy walkway at the bottom of the ridge to overlook the surrounding lower plain.
Witam widza na Kiku, Siwcaka.
Especially unique setting. A small black forest placed in the center of a mountain biome that completely surrounded it with mountains. You know how games have areas where you can't get into locations except for maybe one path in? I started off by surrounding the mountain range with large rocks, leaving a main opening for a front entrance.
Nie, nie, Kamieniusz, to jest stary filmik, w którym pokazuję właśnie mega mapkę, którą przygotowali, wiesz, taką z rozmachem.
Then you pass through the entrance into a cold winter wonderland, passing through castle structures and passing.
Ale swoją drogą w Valheim update był nie tak dawno.
Then heading down to the town, you find traces of winter everywhere, with a large bonfire in the middle, metaphorically fighting back the cold winter that surrounds the town. The final similarity in the towns is what really makes each town feel alive. Each town got roads connecting everything. Each town got unique lampposts. They also got some nature elements that fit the setting. They got some unique water wells for getting water. And some even got boathouses or docks. And when it comes to building in games, there are always some final details to wrap it all up. The meadows got a few beehives, the plains got pagodas or kind of lookouts hanging from chains from the.
O, to zajebiste. To dobry motyw, nie?
The Black Forest Mountain Town got nice.
Że to się trzyma, nie? Bo to tam też jest. Nie wiem, czy wyłączyli to jakoś modem, ale tam. No wiecie, to się musi jakoś wszystko trzymać kupy, bo inaczej. Fizyka na to nie pozwala, ale mogli wyłączyć to.
To walk under on the paths and a bridge going across the center ravine. This meant that the first three towns were done, and I've got to be honest.
Eventually, there's going to be an entire town right here at Worldspawn.
It really made the whole adventure map feel real for the first time. Now Dakar had the Swamp Town, so you'll have to check out his video coming soon on how he did that. And the Mistlands was our favorite idea that we saved to do together at the end. So I started working on the 12 class-themed locations, where you'll be adventuring into the wilderness. Now for these locations, I really don't want to spoil anything, but for the priest, you'll be able to worship the Norse gods in a giant temple where you have to avoid falling into the pool of an ancient sea serpent.
O kurna.
For the ranger, you'll be adventuring up into the trees while fighting an enemy horde that's taken over the ranger outpost to eventually get to the treasure room. And there's even an optional high-level loot room. For the druid, you arrive.
Nie wiem, nawet w MMORPG-ach to czasami takich rzeczy nie ma, nie? W sensie. Często nie ma, tylko wszystko jest takie generyczne i wrzucone na jednej płaszczyźnie bez zamysłu większego. Jak to jest? A chłopy robią moda i nagle masz, nie wiem, startujesz jako łowca w drzewach, bijesz się z przeciwnikami albo w jakiejś świątyni, która jest poświęcona konkretnemu Bogu.
Arrive at a modest boathouse on the edge of a mysterious forest, where you venture inside.
Cześć, Bastik, witam.
To clear out the druid's hidden nature sanctuary. For the Valkyrie, you'll take a journey up high into the clouds, into a castle, to try to find your way through to the end to discover a hidden treasure. Once again, with an optional high-level loot room. For the Shaman, you'll be placed into the darkest setting so far, being forced into the swamp, where you'll be battling enemies and following a treacherous path to hopefully prevail and reach the final loot room. So you can see that just like the main towns, each class-themed location has its own unique theme, like a magical forest, a floating castle, or a scary swamp, while also, just like the towns, sharing some similarities in how they're set up. For example, a lot of them have areas that have to be cleared of enemies. A lot of them have loot rooms at the end. And like I mentioned earlier with the Black Forest Mountain Town, a lot of them have limited ways to enter and exit. Overall, so many ideas went into making every location functional. Something that was only a dream a few weeks before had suddenly become a reality.
Ale się napracowali, no. Masakra.
So 4 weeks after the first message, it was time to send over the world to Dakar, where he could bring in everything that he had been working on. But if you want to get more details on his process, you'll have to go check out his video coming soon. Now, to finish up the whole project, we had 4 things left to do. So first of all, I spent a few days grinding out making some roads and bridges to connect everything in the world. Then the second thing we decided to do was the boss raid arenas, which I think came out pretty cool. Here's a sneak peek.
Arenki bossów.
Then the third thing we did was make 13 locations around the map to fill in the gaps. These are kind of like Easter eggs, so I definitely want people to discover them for the first time naturally.
A, czyli chcą się podzielić tą mapką, żeby samemu pozwiedzać, no. No tak, tak jak mówił na początku.
And finally, we've reached the end of the project, which meant it was time to build the 5th main town that we saved for last. It's in the Mistlands, and we decided to use the islands along the coast for a build theme based on pirates. In the build graveyard, we started off by building up some concepts of ships, and even some concepts of ship houses. We came up with Jolly Roger flags, shipbuilding workshops, and other miscellaneous things. And now, it was time to put it all together into the last town.
Nie, można grać. Wrzucę wam linka na koniec, bo to jest film sprzed kilku miesięcy, Bastik, wiesz? Więc można sobie wgrać na pewno, na 100% już.
Let's talk about how you can play on this map, but first I wanted to remind you that there are a lot of things I didn't show in this video. First of all, Dakar's builds will be in his video coming soon, and the rest are saved for you to see when you play on the world. But for a final few examples, if you know Skyrim and the Thieves Guild, then you'll have a good idea where to look to find something special. And there may even be a famous movie location that I might have teased somewhere in this video. Comment below if you figure it out, and I'll confirm if you got it right. Now moving forward, the world's first Valheim adventure map is complete. Well, kind of. We still have some work to do, but here's some information on how you will be able to play on the world in a few different ways. The map will be playable in 2 forms. First, the open world RPG modded experience on Gathalion's server, and another form where Dakar and I will be converting it to a linear, curated Valheim playthrough that is free and has no mods so that everyone can play. The RPG experience will be live on Gathalion's server in a few months when they finish the mod pack.
Okej, czyli to możliwe, że nie będzie działało ten live serwer, ale trzeba by było zobaczyć.
Become a Twitch subscriber of Gathalion and hop on there and try out just the early version of the mod pack, which they are updating and tweaking all the time. But there is no adventure map yet. And then, if you're interested in the free and unmodded linear version, Dakar and I will be working for the next few weeks to convert the open world to a linear one. This will be a curated Valheim playthrough, where you gather supplies at the class-themed locations, and all of the locations in between, and you then use that supplies to make your next set of gear at each main town. So then, you can go and fight the next boss. This
okay,
will be...
Czyli... W sumie singlowe RPG, nie? Że przechodzisz, progresujesz i pomiędzy miastami kolejnymi jazda.
And if you just can't wait to play the world, you can become an ultimate channel member of my YouTube channel and you can play on the world today and explore the locations before we add all of the enemies and the linear.
No, to myślę, że to już nie jest case'em, że już jest to wydane.
Helpful hint in the free treehouse build that I mentioned in the treehouse video, where you can get some help for the beginning of the.
Zaraz zobaczymy, wiesz, Bastik.
And you can also go ahead.
Ale wydaje mi się, że jak już, to chyba trzeba zostawić subskrypcję u tego gościa, u tego streamera i wtedy się to odblokuje ewentualnie.
And check out one of the builds in the adventure map. So go check it out if you want. Wow. Making this video and this map has been a long time coming.
Ale mega się postarał też przy montażu tego filmu, nie? Description. We did it after a year of planning. Drakar. Czy jest tu jakiś link? Czy jest tu jakiś link? Full story. A, i tu jest już wszystko opisane, jak już skończyli to, tak? Tak, 9 byte. I tu jest, tak, jest gotowe. The first version. I live streams. Ale gdzie jest po prostu link, żeby to pobrać ewentualnie? No, to jest ciekawe. Chyba, że faktycznie trzeba iść do tego streamera i tam zobaczyć. Czekajcie, jak on się nazywał? King Gotalion. Twitch King Gotalion. Zobaczmy, może ma to dalej. King Gotalion. O, nawet streamuje, ty. Czy z Valheima? Wątpię. Nie, First Descendant. O kurde, 4700 widzów. Ale tutaj nie ma żadnych informacji w sumie. Może u niego na Discordzie coś? No, trzeba by było poszukać. Trzeba by było poszukać. Chyba, że na YouTubie. No, chyba trzeba się bardziej zagłębić. Czyli wejść do niego na Discorda i tam poszukać jakichś linków i zobaczyć, jak to działa. Bo tak to nie ma łatwego po prostu, wiecie. Linka do pobrania i do przodu. No. Jest jak jest. Jest jak jest. Jest jak jest. Tam jest napisane w opisie? Gdzie? All of my builds? No, ale mówili o darmowej zupełnie wersji, Tomasz, wiesz? Mówił o darmowej wersji, która będzie open world. Chyba, że się pozmieniało i teraz to po prostu sprzedaje, nie? Ale można zobaczyć, czekaj. Wesprzyj. Więcej o bonusach. Advanced. Advanced Membership World Downloads in Discord. Aha, czyli za 20 zł można pobierać dopiero te światy prawdopodobnie, nie? Bo 8 zł to nic, ale za 20 zł można pobierać. No, także tak czy siak prawdopodobnie jest to w jakiś sposób zmonetyzowane, nie? Więc jak ktoś chce pograć, to chyba musi wesprzeć. Stety albo niestety. I ufundować kolejne prace. kurde, 570 tysięcy, a jak skończyli, 84 tysiące wyświetleń, ale tyle, co się opierdzieli z tym montażem, no przedupcone, przedupcone. A tutaj pewnie też dużo pracy. Nie, nie, to jest chyba po prostu... ewentualne, wiecie, elementy budowli, które też można pobrać z jego Discorda, czy coś w ten sposób, czy coś w ten deseń. No dobrze, dobrze, dobrze. Ale generalnie cały świat mega spoko, mega spoko. Fajnie jakby z takim zamysłem też te światy MMORPG-owe były robione, a nie tylko, kurczę, w jakichś gierkach survivalowych, multiplayerowych.